been told to come, the National Museum of Photography, Film and Television. And I tell you, this is a very obscure one. I've been armed with a magnifying glass and I've been told to look for a serious amateur. Let's go in. Hi. Hello. Is there a section called the serious amateur?
Yes.
Or the amateur photographer or yes, something or other? Where's that?
Downstairs through Kodak. Where it says the Kodak
okay, museum. Right. You've seen the serious amateur section?
It's upstairs.
Upstairs?
Yeah.
Ah, we've just been sent downstairs. The clock thickens.
Wait,
I think it's up here.
Here we are. Serious amateur. What is pictorialism? The disappearing darkroom. See the world's best snapshot. Join the club. How are you? Is there anything strange about this room? Because we've been told to look for our challenge and I've no idea where to look and I've been given a magnifying glass. No, it's not you, is it? What are you looking at then? Hang on.
I've just seen something.
What's that?
My little girl's hand.
Oh. Oh, that's brilliant. How have they done that? This is the magnifying glass, you see? Organise an exhibition of photographs for the 1992 Childline Calendar Children at Play PTO. Am I doing something I shouldn't do? Oh well, it's done now. P.S. Childline doesn't yet have a 1992 calendar. Collect hundreds of photographs of children from all over Britain and produce 10,000 copies of the calendar by the time the exhibition opens at 4 o'clock on Friday. You've got to make a calendar. Do you think I can just pull that off? Done it. Where does one start? I suppose one phones up Childline or something. That's Esther Ransom's charity. Hello.
Hello.
An official person has arrived.
An official person.
Hello, Penny.
I work here at the museum.
Yeah.
That's the area where we'd like you to organise the exhibition.
Oh, let's have a look at it. It's got a title and everything up. So it is actually officially called Children at Play.
It is now.
And what's it got to depict? Children at play.
Children at play.
Nothing
yes,
more
everybody's
as general as that.
Everybody's kids, that's right.
So you're expecting us to have this whole room decked out at 4 o'clock on Friday?
Anything up to 50 photographs mounted on the walls, if
right.
You would.
So we better get going, hadn't we?
Is that Esther Ransom?
Speaking.
Esther, it's Anneka.
Annie,
what have you
me?
Done? What's going on here then? I better explain. Of course, you know Esther is the founder of Childline and she's a friend. And I've got a terrible feeling she's stitched me up good and proper this time. What's going on? What is it?
Well, you know Childline gets 10,000 attempted phone calls every day.
Yeah.
So at the moment we can only answer about 2,000 of those. Maybe a calendar for next year which had 10,000 copies might raise a little bit of money which would pay for some of those phone
yeah.
calls.
Yeah, I mean it's a lovely idea. Is there anything about the photographs that you want from your point of view?
I want them to radiate happiness.
So very positive.
Very, very positive.
Right. Okay. Thanks, Esther. Bye. Well, you heard that. Photographs radiating happiness, positive children at play. The most pressing problem, of course, is the actual calendar, which will need to be printed and all the photographs processed. And how on earth could we organise hundreds of people all over Britain? Prince's View Wine and Coffee Bar. Oh, hello. The only thing I can think of, we had a challenge last year where we had to produce a joke book. And that was a real joke, because we had to do that literally overnight. And that was Butler and Tanner. Now listen, have you got a camera? Peter, I just wondered if we could find a way of getting everyone taking photographs, whether you could possibly help us again.
We could print a calendar, we couldn't finish it, that's the problem here.
Have you got a camera? You have to go home and get one. Go home and get one and leave the prints at reception, okay?
I know a company in Nottingham called Howitt.
Right.
I don't have, I'm in the factory at the moment. I don't have the number to hand,
well, that's
Anneka,
OK. I can ring up directly.
All right.
Inquiry.
Oh!
Sorry. Oh!
Sorry.
Oh, goodness, you're in a hurry. Hello there. Can I talk to someone about calendars?
I actually am my own and I can't talk to anyone at the moment. Actually, you're phoning a newsagent.
Newsagent?
There you are indeed.
Oh, I'm sorry, I thought you were a publisher or a printer.
Oh, there is,
I'm sorry.
Sorry.
Exactly you at play.
He's a child.
He's a very tall child. Hi, do you make calendars?
Yes, we do.
We have to produce a calendar by Friday at 4 o'clock.
That's a challenge.
It could be on our calendar.
Yeah, you'd like that.
Exactly like that.
Well, we're going to have the photograph by tomorrow.
By tomorrow?
Evening, yes, at least.
The main problem at the moment is all these wonderful people start taking photos, and if somehow we can get an appeal out on radio or television tonight, tomorrow morning, get people taking photographs wherever they are of children at play, we then need some sort of method of collecting all those photographs. Chaos, sorry. You good at photography?
Who, me? Personally, not very much.
Good afternoon, Red Star.
Hello there, it's Anneka Rice here from the Challenge Programme. Hello.
Oh, goodness.
We're stuck and we need your help.
Oh.
The printer's in Nottingham.
Right.
We're in Bradford. You're in London.
You want it by...
The photographer could be in Cornwall for all
tomorrow afternoon.
Yeah.
By the way, I assume you want all this for free, do you?
Yes, excuse me.
Right. We've got to get them to Nottingham. I think we'll have them at Derby, because that's the main line junction. I should probably get fired now, but...
Roger, you won't get fired. Just put all the blame on Dave. That's what we always do.
Don't you be sad, just call me tonight.
We've been in touch with the BBC and they very kindly agreed to clear their schedule so that we can make an appeal on air tonight. Well, I say clear the schedule, they've actually given us a 30-second slot which will go out just before EastEnders. So the most important thing to do now is we come here to BBC Leeds, which is the largest BBC station nearby. We've actually got to film this appeal and Dave, it's got to be exactly 30 seconds long. You're in charge of timing.
I'll get my stopwatch ready.
We need hundreds and hundreds of photographs of children at play. Take them along to your local British Rail Red Star parcel point. They'll do all the rest. Just get them along.
Two.
Right, it's going so well.
Take two.
Now, if at home you've got any shots, any prints of your children playing... What's that?
That was a few seconds to go, Annie. I was going to do that just so you know time's running out. Well, it's 33 seconds now, anyway. Do you want any light on, Martin?
Yes, please.
Right.
Can we try and make this look a bit more professional?
Okay, take five.
Don't forget, please help. Colour photos, children at play. Go and do it now! What's happened?
37.
Why didn't you tell me it was...
I did one of them, Annie. Did you see me?
Yeah, I saw that, but then you didn't.
Well, you're going so well, I just didn't have the heart to stop you.
Talk about chaos. We have the tape. Is someone expecting us with
yes.
it?
Fine, yes.
Oh, brilliant. It's 2 seconds longer than we said. Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Six.
Now, took six takes. Oh, you bastard.
Anytime at all you gotta do is go, and I'll be there. If the sun has faded away, I'll try to make it shine. There is nothing now.
Well, tonight, eventually, we've got to end up in Nottingham so we can get to the printers for first thing tomorrow morning. But on the way down the motorway, we suddenly realised it was nearly 7:30. We wanted to see if our appeal was actually going to be transmitted. So we thought we'd stop off at a little village called Osset. Just passed it on the way down, and here we are. Oh, gosh. Do you know if there's a telly anywhere? Of
challenge starts in a few weeks' time. Right now, we're actually filming it. We've just been given a challenge by Childline, the charity. If you've got any photographs at home of children playing and you can bear to part with them, take them along to your local British Rail Red Star parcel point. Address it to Red Star Derby. We need the photographs at the latest by 4 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. Please try and help us.
The message hasn't got through to you, I despair. Do you think that was okay?
I mean, yeah, it was fine, yeah.
It was very quick. But, I mean, we were only allowed 30 seconds. Printers at Nottingham tomorrow morning. Doesn't seem to be a lot more we can do tonight, which is a shame being stuck in a pub, doesn't it?
It's going to be tough.
It's going to be a shame. Three mineral waters, please. I believe that nobody knows. Good morning, we've come to the local station in Nottingham now to check out the Red Star parcel point and see if any photographs have been sent in as a result of that appeal. It's now, I haven't got my watch on, but 7 o'clock, I think. Good morning.
Morning.
Okay. Good morning. Hi. Has anyone sent in anything for?
Swear we sent one up last night.
One?
One as a note to, because we've got reprinted the label.
What?
We've only been open 10 minutes. We've got two from British Rail staff so far.
Oh, not hundreds of sackfills.
No, give people time, it's early yet.
Right.
We've only been open 10 minutes.
Oh. Crushed. Can we wait here? We're so nervous that no one's actually going to.
Can we give it time?
Shall we have a look at these two? Oh, brilliant. Oh, well, good old British Rail staff.
One from the buffet, one from the travel centre.
Sorry, I'm just too excited. We've got to see one photograph in the flesh just to know. I bought my camera today. Oh, we have this sort of sinking feeling that.
Don't have a sinking
feeling. Oh, that's lovely. Oh, that's lovely, isn't it? Do pass on our thanks.
No problem.
You see those people. We may be back.
Yeah.
I feel really depressed about this because I don't know what I imagined. Somehow a room stacked full of sackfuls of photographs. And it is early in the day and they could come in later, but I just have a problem now. Now, what we're going to do now is try and get hold of Simon Mayo on the breakfast show. See if we can just make a quick appeal just to back up what we did last night. Dave, mine will be a black coffee. A bacon roll. Dave!
Here you go, Annie.
Dave, that's so sweet, thank you.
Hello, Anneka.
Who's that?
It's Rick, the producer.
Hello, Rick. Listen, is that okay if we make an appeal?
Yeah, that's not a problem.
Is that okay?
We're just going to go into the news and then come to you. So, do you want to ring back in 5 minutes?
Ring back in 5 minutes.
Yeah. Now, are you travelling at the moment? Are you actually mobile?
No, we're on a mobile. We're in a station buffet. Is that okay?
Yeah, it just sounds like you maybe the signal may not be too good.
Oh, really? Try phone box.
Would this be Anneka Rice on line 5?
Simon, you're such a star, and thank you to everyone listening, and get sorting through those photo albums.
What about miserable, fed-up children getting their head off?
No, none of them. This is meant to be a happy calendar.
And you want it by today?
We want it by today, Simon. We're off to the printers now to meet everyone there, see what lies ahead today, tomorrow, and the next day. There we go, Howitt. Over for the next few days, just go find Joe Slack. Just testing. Hi! Which is Joe?
I am Joe.
Hello, David.
Good morning.
Martin.
Hello there.
Thank you so much for saying you can help us.
I hope we can.
Well, I hope we can. Well, where do we start? I mean,
well, I think the best idea is we sit down and generally go through what we can do.
Good
for
idea.
You.
I think because, what we're hoping is that we're going to get hundreds, of photographs, and obviously to show as many as possible. Mm-hmm. But actually, seeing that, I think that kind of idea is nice. Mm-hmm. One main-ish photo, yeah. Again, if they're of a quality that will. Mm-hmm.
I think it really
blow
does depend obviously on the selection you're going to get. That's the sort of
with this sort of rather ad hoc,
right?
At angles around it's rather. Right. I think. But are you a designer?
No, but no. I've got a guy who we use quite a lot. It's not as bad as it looks. Oh.
So where does the designer live?
He's on Gregory Boulevard, which is about 6 minute drive from here.
How long would it normally take to produce a calendar like the one we're planning?
It would take several weeks of planning, really.
Yes.
But nothing this fast.
Have you ever done one in 3 days before?
No.
Well, it's actually, it's only 2 days now.
It actually is.
Right.
Hi.
Hello.
Robert.
Yeah.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
So she's landed you in it good and proper.
What have you done?
I'm sorry about this.
We've got to do a calendar for the charity Childline. And the whole thing has got to be completed and finished and ready by Friday.
Friday?
Yes. And it's what, we've started designing
it. Just the design?
No, the whole lot.
The whole
printing.
Thing.
What are you doing today?
Has she done this?
Yeah, I promise you, it was nothing to do with what you were meant to be doing today. What are you doing?
Illustrating.
Example, as it were. Oh, we'll have something like that, but, you know, on a calendar.
But you've only got two pictures so far.
They should come in thick and fast today, we hope. But as I say, they're not yet.
Pop it on there. That's nice.
Just in case the photos aren't quite up to scratch, we could use all the illustrations you could muster.
Right.
In fact, it could be huge illustrations. You're better at soup, actually.
It's a letter for Challenge Anneka.
We need the logo.
Just take that off. Just take that off and leave it in.
Would you like to see some
underway?
Very rough.
Design.
Give it to that man.
Thank you very much.
Hi! Are these all your children?
No.
Oh. One, listen, I'll tell you what we're doing. We're involved in a challenge at the moment.
Yeah.
Could I possibly take a photo? Is this your little boy?
Well, it's not mine. I look after him, but go ahead.
It wouldn't matter.
No.
The owner won't mind.
That's why she's not taking the photo.
I'm so excited. Now, let's try and get him doing something interesting. Would you come? What's your name?
Nikki.
Nikki, can you come with me a minute? I want to show you something.
No.
This is lesson one, how to take photographs, get to know your subject. So how's life, Nikki? Is it good? I'll just sort of get going. He's doing fine.
Nikki!
What did you have to say about happy, smiling faces? Where's Nikki?
Peepo!
Baby face, you've got the cutest little baby face.
Big smile, the hugest smile. Look at, where's Dave gone? Dave usually provoke the smile.
Baby face.
That's brilliant,
something.
Charlie.
Really
good.
Started something, baby.
When you come down, I want you to look really happy, like this.
Hooray!
Excuse me, there wasn't one smile on your face then. I think we're lacking something. Dave, the ice cream shot.
Yeah, I've got you one, that's great.
For the children. Can you get about 15?
Yeah.
Can you do us some ice creams, please?
That's all we need is 15 cones.
Oh, no, no.
15, please. You got some money?
I've got any hundreds of thousands for my one.
And that strawberry stuff we've got on it, nuts.
Oh, yeah. Oh, they're for the kids.
Oh, I've got two more, Martin. I ordered two more than we need.
Dave, what have you done? Oh, damn. Okay. Okay, have you got me? You got your ice cream!
I think it's definitely, look, that child is animated.
I'm going to take a photo of this little boy.
But he don't look at you.
He don't look at me, no.
Looks at me though, don't
he? See, all right, you go for it, and you do what Dave's just failed miserably to do.
Good boy.
Oh, that's nice. How have we gone so horribly wrong? Do you know where there's one of those photographic hour jobbers, you know, where you put your film in and get it in an hour?
No idea.
Okay. I just wish I wasn't in this bus lane. What went wrong? It was Dave, you said, down there. And I've got it on film.
Yeah. Oh, but we were on the road then, Annie. We were on lots of other cars.
Sorry, you don't know where one of those processing things is? Processing centres.
I've no idea at all.
No. Yes.
Back down here.
No.
Cross over.
No. Can't be back down there.
Back down here. We'll cross over the road. Back down here. First junction. Turn left. It's on the left hand side.
Okay.
Great favour and develop those.
We can't do it straight away, we can only do it overnight.
Can you?
Yes.
Really?
Certainly.
Oh, my goodness. Sort of what could be the shortest time?
1:50, about 10 to 2.
Right. Have you got three chairs we can sit on until then? That's great. One, two, three. Is that the first lot? Come out! They've all come out. This is a miracle, a complete miracle. We just want, you know, one that says it all. That's quite nice. Oh, that's lovely, Dave.
Oh, yeah.
Super.
What a chest.
Right, well, there's some there. I have to say, thank you so much for that. I'm so thrilled that they've come out. Yeah. And they're off to Radio Derby, to British Rail, to see whether some real folks.
You should be all right.
Yeah, I hope so.
Sorry to interrupt you. I'm DC Neil from the CID at Derby. Yeah. I understand you were filming on Iron Gate this morning. We've had a robbery. Believe it or not, we think you may have captured the robber on your film. I wonder if I could have a look and see if he's there.
I thought you were going to tell me about the bus. Yes, so
could
we could rewind and...
Yes, please.
Just in case the suspect...
Well, that's right.
Should we go upstairs
please.
And do that?
Thanks very much. Yes. That's the core market. Now, the bank is directly in front of you.
Should we put it on hold? It's my mum's home. Technical after all these years.
It's one won't stop.
Oh no, look, we got a hold, now we've got your elbow on your arm. Maybe.
Yeah, no, there's.
Whoa, one elbow looks very much like another.
BBC Radio Derby.
Derby detectives at a study a TV film being shot in the city. They believe a crew filming for the BBC Challenge Anneka programme may have captured the
there
man.
There we go. Red Star Parcel Point. Have they received any photograph? Hello.
Hello.
How's it going?
All right. The computers have gone down there.
Oh, you're joking. What
yeah, but we've got a big
through?
Group. Yeah, climb over.
Can we?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, hello. It's the police again. Been with a colleague of yours. You're not after that
rubber
story, are you?
No, I'm not.
Oh, right, OK.
Keeping out of the way.
Oh, look! And so this is just so far, is it?
Yeah.
I mean, there's more to come?
That's right. Yeah.
We've come from all different places, look, from Stephen Ocean.
Oh, everyone's just brilliant, what people have done. Goodness, this is going to take forever to get through. Sorry, I'm so excited. We've now got a potential calendar. Mind you, we haven't seen the quality of the photos. Let's just open one at random. We got here. Where's this one from? Northampton. It's just down the motorway. Just have a quick sneak preview at one of them. I can't wait.
Sure it's the right appeal?
It's lovely. In its own way, that is a lovely photo. Thank you very much, Rachel. I'll put that back, sellotape it up, so we can make sure we don't miss that one later on.
Anneka!
Hello! Have you just brought one in for us?
Yes.
Oh, that's lovely. Who's this?
That is my mate.
Your mate? They've just come from every corner of the nation.
The train just going, is that just off that train?
We better get loading up the buggy.
Like that, Ned,
eh? Oh, yes. Not too far, Ken, it'll blow away.
Right, then.
This, ladies and gentlemen, is just the tip of the iceberg. We have here a team of volunteers from the Childline office. This is going to be a very long process. And over there, we've compiled some trays, January through to December. And what we'd love you to do at this stage is just to make a very preliminary selection. Imagine it on your kitchen wall. It's got to be a photograph you've got to look at for 30 days in a month. This is the first pile. There are literally lorry loads on their way. Rejects in there.
Oh,
get
fresh, man. What a big check, click. What a
picture,
what a photograph.
That's quite nice. It says beach, it says all
good.
That one,
go. Stamp your feet, banging on the big bass drum. What a picture, umtilly um, bum, 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 bum. Stick it in your family album.
Completely out of control now. I hope this is your last lot.
No, I think there's a load more.
Oh no. Oh my god. Brilliant. Keep all the jiffy bags because obviously we'll send them back to recycling. Let me just interrupt for one moment because someone very important has just arrived. This is Paul Williams from a company called
Hello.
Euroscan, and they're going to be responsible for all the reproduction of the photographs and the artwork and everything like that. Put it. Am I saying this right?
That's right.
You make film.
We make films from these photographs.
Yes.
We
take the photographs and electronically scan them so that they can be used in a printed way, if you like, basically.
We'll ask you questions on that later on, so I hope you're taking that in. Pandemonium in here now. We're overwhelmed by just how many photographs have arrived. I'm off to the designers now to see how Bob's getting on. I think I'll leave them to it.
No, so just
well,
that one.
Yeah.
All
right.
Oh, that's very nice.
Right.
A little bit dark, though.
Time for shot. It's a bit dark. Yeah.
Bob! How are you doing?
Oh, great. On number six illustration now. Seven.
We've got some great photos. Yeah. But we'll just pop in on, you know, on our way through and rushing around and going mad to see how you're
doing. Well,
we'll
be here till midnight, I think, especially with the illustrations.
Well, come and join us. We'll be down the road burning midnight oil.
Will you?
So we'll meet you. See you at 2 a.m.
Clement, stamp your feet, banging on the big bass drum. What a picture, run to the ump, pump, 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 steady and ready.
Well, there we go. 4 hours later, it's now 9:30, you must be totally knackered and you probably never want to see another photo again. They have been brilliant. They've sifted through thousands and thousands of photographs and come down, really narrowed it down to just a few per month. So thank you everybody who sent them in. We've now got the very difficult decision of whittling these few down to an even narrower proportion. And these are the few that never quite saw the light of day. I mean, I can't understand why if you look at it. That could have done for August, couldn't it, though? Stunning. Don't you think? That is actually very nice. Children at play, I'm not sure about the theme there. And as for this one, whoever you are, we'd like to get hold of you. This is the beginning of a very long, agonising selection process. And this is Alison Seymour, who's joined us now, who's the director of Childline in the Midlands. We thought it was necessary to have your input. Very important. Everybody's opinion at this stage. I don't know where on earth we start. Paul, are there any that sort of grab you as natural?
Well, being as we're looking at December and January, obviously the snow shots stand out. I mean, this is a lovely shot of children going down on their sledges.
That's a magnificent snowman, Adam Jones, and Mr. Frosty, that is.
That's very good.
Oh, there's a Father Christmas. It's the first Father Christmas we've got.
He's happy, though, doesn't he?
Great joy there.
It's a bit of a disaster there. We got for March because
three at a push. Two we're quite keen on. Yeah. One we're not so keen.
These are the ones we took today.
Yours are taken in August.
No, but you wouldn't know.
You see this guy here?
Cool dude.
Finally November, because we've done December and January together. Maybe. Oh, there's some good ones here. That's lovely.
Yeah, it's a good Yeah, that can be popcorn.
I'm so tired now. Have you noticed we're sort of talking very slowly, taking a long time to react? We've now selected the photos. Bob's done his layout. Got my watch on. It's midnight. And it's now back to Paul's studio for the next part of the process to begin. OK, Paul?
Pardon? I can't hear a word you're saying. It's lovely out here. There's no better way to travel, eh? Just turn in here if you want, Annie.
Here?
Yeah, this one here.
Well, it looks a bit empty.
I tell you, then, there'll be no one here. Nobody normally works at this unearthly hour. It's dark.
It's dark.
Oh! OK, guys. Let's just give young Alex a ring, OK? Because he's going to come in and start help mounting with some prints. There's a certain young lady here who would appreciate it. Will you give us a hand?
Poor Alex.
All right.
He's just put on his gym jam.
You've just sat down and had your cocoa. Well, never mind. Yeah. OK, then, cheers. See you in a bit. Bye-bye.
All through the night, I'll be awake and I'll be with you.
It's Bob.
Hello, Bob. Just here. Finally finished.
Well done. You've done the most brilliant job here.
when time is new.
It's quite exciting when you see the photographs actually laid cool. down.
Well done. Well done, that chap.
Good morning. Well, it's a very, very special day today. Not only is the calendar really beginning to take shape in there, but it's Dave's birthday!
Oh, yes! You remembered, Annie?
We've thought so long and hard about this, Dave. And
what can I say? You remembered.
This has got great meaning and poignancy. It's just, we decided you were doing so badly as a sound man. We were going to try anything.
I need something, Annie, yeah. Hey, Martin, look at this.
And we thought if we tried you with a different job, you couldn't be any worse.
This is going to be... Oh, a clapperboard as well.
So, you know, take one.
OK.
And pull the string and it all happened.
I think it's jammed. Oh, no. There we go.
Anything you can do, we can do better. We can do anything better than you. Yes, we can. Yes, we can. Yes, we can. Yes, we can. Yes, we can.
Peter!
Oh, yeah.
How are you doing?
Right, my girl.
Look at it! It looks fantastic. Seriously, what do you think? You must have seen enough calendars go to.
Oh, yes. Quite a few.
But what do you think of this one?
Very good at the moment.
It's not bad, yeah, is not it? Bad. Considering last night we hadn't even chosen
the
photographs.
Yeah.
I'm thrilled, actually.
Happy birthday, Dave. Take one.
Well, the printing is still going on. Well done, Dave, in there. It'll be going on all through the night until at least 7 o'clock tomorrow morning. Paul's still busy with his photographs. Just looking at the original challenge again. It says, organise an exhibition of photographs from the 1992 Childline Calendar Children at Play. So I thought, while there's a bit of a lull from our point of view, i.e. we can't actually help them with the printing process in there, we'd have a think about this exhibition. So I'm just trying to get through to that lady Penny we met at Bradford. Penny, it's Anneka again.
Hello, how are you getting on?
Well, we had the most fantastic response with the photographs. We had over 4,000. But looking at the challenge, we've got to organise this exhibition, haven't we? But what sort of happens next?
Can I put you through to our exhibition designer?
Yes.
She's called Imelda Kay, and I'll see if she's there.
Oh, Imelda, it's Anneka Rice here. I've just been talking to Penny. She was saying that we should have the photographs enlarged and mounted.
Yes. There is a company in Leeds that we use a lot.
Yeah.
Who I'm sure would
help. Who are they?
They're Warren.
Oh, wonderful.
Well, I've actually just heard one of my photographs is going in the calendar.
Is it? You just sent it into Derby?
I
don't believe it.
That's brilliant. Wow, I'm still reading it.
How extraordinary. Okay. We'll see you later then.
Thank
Thanks
you.
For your help. Bye. Bye-bye. We're off to Leeds.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Good to see you. Right, now,
well,
shall I?
Want to just lay out here to see what we've got.
Let me show you what we've got. What we've got is we've got the photographs up to August.
Right.
Still to come September, October, November, December. Right. Which was your photo?
It's the boy with the yellow bucket on his head, if it rings a bell.
Yeah, bucket on his head.
I think it's in May, Penny. I think I remember.
May, you think May? This is so funny. I mean, out of over 4,000 photos, Imelda sent hers, like everybody else, along to Red Star at Derby, and we actually selected it.
There he is.
Oh, Ian, you're such a star helping us at this 11th hour. What exactly
can you do then? You do the actual mounts,
well, I think
do you?
That's right. What we need to do is get these copied to the sizes. Then we've got to mount on card, which we must get in touch with Wiggins Teep. They'll supply the card.
For the card, will they?
Yep. So, and then, well, it's ready for display.
How extraordinary. You just put it in like a photocopier in the corner.
Right.
It's so clever. Look at that.
Lucy Hallett.
Miss Lucy Hallett, Somerset. There she is. So while Ian and Imelda are busy putting the actual exhibition together here in Leeds, back at Nottingham, Paul is still scanning the remaining photographs, and the presses at the printers are going to be rolling all through the night. It's going to be a very long night for everyone. Last month, December, doesn't it look amazing? All the months are now being cut up individually. They'll be loaded onto the pallet and taken off to be collated now into the proper calendar. Let's go. Okay, ladies, are you ready for it? Here it comes. This is the collating machine where all the individual months are collected together. They're then put in a pile by Mary just down there, and this finally is the binding machine where all the holes are punched in, the spirally bits put on, and this is the very first Children at Play 1992 calendar, exactly 65 hours after we were first given the challenge. That is so exciting. It looks fantastic. The only problem is there's still 9,999 still to be put together. Oops. While all that printing process is going on, we thought we'd actually come and visit the local Childline office. The calendar, of course, is full of happy, smiling children without a care in the world. What the charity is about is just the opposite.
Hello, are you through to Childline? Yes. You're saying you're being beaten up by Dad. Right, let me just stop you there. You've come through to the switchboard here at Childline, and I'm going to put you through to speak to a counsellor.
What sort of calls do you get?
Children who are being bullied by other children. Sometimes children who want to come away from home because they're getting fed up of what's being done, and, or being hit by parents. And sometimes being sort of well, physically or sexually abused.
And then what kind of help can you offer?
I mean, the most important thing we do is listen, and then we help the young person to look at what options might be available to them about what they want to do, and then they have to make their own decision.
Do you want to tell me a bit more about what's been happening?
I think having somebody here who they can sort of really trust and say anything to is the most important thing.
Because they know that none of that information is going to go beyond
Outside Childline. Yes.
What are they doing to, I mean, what's exactly happening when you go out to play?
Do you hear back afterwards from children who might...
Yes, I was on shift yesterday and we had three people ringing up to say thank you, and that was quite nice.
And you feel that there's nobody talking to you? That you don't have any friends?
Perhaps you could tell me a bit more about what you feel about your dad.
And how do you feel when they argue?
And it makes you feel dreadful.
Childline is so famous now, and you have this very strong image of a child in trouble making a phone call. And I think it's nice now for children to see the other end of the operation, that you are there along with your colleagues, smiling and caring and ready to help. So it's been great to come along to this office. And of course, this is just the office representing the Midlands area. Any child from anywhere in Britain can call that number, 0800 11 11.
that same number for whichever region they're in.
That's true.
Anyway, look, I can see it's a busy time for you all. Thank you very much. And will you say goodbye to the others because they're all on calls? Thanks a million. Bye.
And I know even more, the work you've done for us over the last 3 days mean that there's a bit of a backlog on other projects that should have been finished, so you've got a lot of extra work and a lot of extra hours to put in once we've gone. So thank you so much, thank you so much. We better get this to Bradford, and I hope you enjoy the calendar, put it on your kitchen wall. Bye. Bye. Museum of Photography now. Oh, excuse me, look at that clock on the clock tower. 4:03-ish. Not bad. The challenge said 4 o'clock. I think that's pretty good. Oh my goodness, everyone's here. Hi! Here's the calendar. Let me just go on upstairs. I recognize all these faces from the photographs, don't I? Look at everybody. We made it. 4:05 now, I think. That's not bad, is it? A number! Oh, look at it. Hi. Look at it all. Isn't that fabulous? Well done. Well done. Recently taken, I think.
Yes.
When was the photo taken?
About May.
About May?
Yes.
And it's in May.
And it's in May.
Well, that was lucky, wasn't it, William? We got it right there.
My birthday, isn't it?
Yes, this is his birthday month, which is a coincidence.
Excuse me, this is extraordinary. When was that actually taken?
When I was 6 years old on my birthday.
Oh, well, we pretended it was Christmas because we needed it. Oh dear.
Gregory, yeah.
Something that's so beautiful.
And so we've done 10,000, so you know, hopefully they'll sell. And
oh, in fact, can I just say, excuse me everybody, I've got a great bit of news which I thought I'd hold back until this moment, but we have heard that WH Smith are going to take all 10,000 calendars and sell them in the shops. So that is terrific news. Hopefully in the next few weeks they'll go like hotcakes and Childline will have a nice fat check.
I know what you've done. You've paid for a complete phone line. You've paid for a year, 24 hours a day, all the calls for the children.